Gary Balance walks over and goes, "Why are you talking to him? You know he's a paki. He's not a sheikh, he's got no oil." Pretty early on, me and other people from Asian background, there was comments such as, "You lot sit over there near the toilets," elephant washers, the word paki was used constantly, and there just seems to be an acceptance in the institution from the leaders, and no one ever stamped it out. Towards the end of my first spell, but constantly throughout it, I knew there was something wrong, but I couldn't quite put my finger on what was wrong. I started taking medication for my mental health, and it was tough, really tough. The first few months I came back, I thought, you know what, things have changed here. It's a little bit different. Alex Leeds was a captain, who was a friend, and he's a good person. And I know he had personal tragedies of himself at a young age, so he understood me. We had Jason Gillespie, the Australian cricketer and coach, who I felt supported by. Jason left at the end of 2016, and it just felt, wow, the temperature in the room had just been turned up. You got Andrew Gale coming in as coach and Gary Balance as captain. And these guys, for me, they were in Yorkshire through and through, and they, as they call it, the White Rose values were embedded in them. For the first time, I started to see for what it was. Felt isolated, humiliated at times, constant use of the word paki. In 2017 pre-season tour, we were in a place and Gary Balance walks over and goes, "Why are you talking to him? You know he's a paki." Or, "He's not a sheikh, he's got no oil." And this happened in front of teammates. It happened in front of coaching staff. We were on a bus trip in London to Surrey game, and we went past a couple of men with beard, and it was like, "Oh, is that your dad? If we go past a corner shop, or does your uncle own this?" And this happened in front of, again, Martin Moxon, Andrew Gale, club officials, and it would never got stamped out. Everyone saw it. But because the institution and the environment, it becomes such a norm in there that I don't think anyone thought there was anything wrong with it. And that's probably why some people don't even remember it. End of 2017, we had a really difficult pregnancy. And through that time, the treatment that I received from some of the club officials were inhuman. They weren't really bothered about the fact that I was at training one day and I get a phone call to say there's no heartbeat. Sorry.